As a recent college graduate, I completely understand the process of trying to find programs online to help you finish your projects a lot easier. There's a video online that'll essentially give me all the information I need to write my paper. Perfect. There's a website that'll help me put my presentation slides better together so that I get a better grade. Great. There's a company that made a video editor that is easier to use than almost every other video editor, so I don't have to learn certain programs. Amazing. And by the way, the last one is the one we're talking about today. There's no need to learn a traditional video editor, such as iMovie if you have a Mac, or Premiere if you have anything, if you don't have to. I suggest finding a product that is made for you, made for the person that's not the film student and somebody that still needs to do a video project. The less headache in college, the better. So Type Studio is an online video editor that anybody can use. And it's not your typical beginner level basic video editor that you'll find online. It has quite a few different features to it that'll help you make your presentation a little bit more professional looking. You can add images, you can add graphics, you can add text, you can add subtitles, you can translate those subtitles. It's a lot of different things that'll make your video presentation for your social studies class or your philosophy class a little bit better. Did I just say social studies? I don't think it's even called social studies in college. Who am I? It's been 2 years since I've been out of college and I'm already calling social studies. And maybe it'll put a nice little smile on your face because you know that you put in less time than everybody else in that class. Well, maybe not everybody else in the class, because some people didn't do the assignment. But of the people that did do the assignment, you definitely spent the least amount of time and still got a good grade. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna go to Type Studio's website, you're gonna go up to the top right, and you're gonna sign up for a free account if you have not done so already, and it will bring you to the dashboard. Go ahead and start a new project and either drag your video in if you already have it pre-recorded, and you can just let it upload right there, or Type has its own webcam recorder feature that you can also use. So if you want to open up the PowerPoint and record your video while presenting the slides, you can do that right here. After you've said your piece and you are done recording your face, click the record button again and it will ask for you to confirm the language spoken in the video so that it can start uploading and transcribing into the program. Once done uploading, you'll be met with the video editor itself. As a quick tour, on the left-hand side, you have the transcribed dialogue that we will be using to cut the video. And on the right, you have the video preview of the video where you can also watch the video back right there, as well as move the visual aspects around in that little area, just so you can make it look how you want to make it with all the graphics and such. So to be safe and help you figure out how well this program will work for you, I'll show you all the different features that Type has to offer so you can kind of run wild with it if you'd like. But first, if you're using this as a way to create a video presentation, what we're gonna do is we're gonna need to get those presentation slides. So head over to your presentation program of choice. And for me, it's Google Slides because it's free. And you're going to want to start downloading the slides from there. We're doing this so that we have the visual elements that we can display behind our face video, so it's like a presentation with our face on it. So essentially creating the typical video presentation. With all the slides downloaded, we can head back to Type and begin the image uploading process. Again, scale down your face a little bit to make room for the presentation slides, then click the plus button and then add image. Get into your downloads and drag the first slide into the web page and let it upload in there. Now scale it so that it fits the whole screen and then send it to the back. And then we can repeat this process with all the other slides so that it's like video and then slide behind it. However, before you do that, there's a slight difference in how you're going to upload these next slides. In order to identify where the slides will appear on screen, there are two icons that you'll find on the left-hand side. It is like the image icon and then also there's a column. And this is important because if you want to get a good grade, then you probably want what you're talking about in the video to match what's on screen. So in order to do that, these icons and columns indicate the points where the image will start and end. So you're gonna have to maneuver them to make it so that you're talking about the right ones that are on screen. To do that, you can drag and drop these different icons in the ideal spots that you'd like them to be, and then proceed to highlight the next part where you would like the next slide to live on. If that doesn't make any sense verbally, just like follow what's on screen because that will make a lot more sense. Now do this specific thing for all the next slides going forward so that it's like you have the highlighted sections and they're living where they need to be, where you're actually talking about them. So now that you got that whole thing nailed down, Type Studio is also a video editor in the way that you can edit the transcript here, which will be useful when if you are to add subtitles to your video. But you can also cut out entire phrases or words from being said throughout the video as well, like making complete cuts on the video. But first, by clicking the enter button on any word, you enter into the editing mode where you can change what it says, and then that will later transfer into the subtitles if you are to add subtitles. But then about the cutting the video part, if you have a portion of the recording that you messed up, don't worry, because you can just cut it out. Highlight the words or sentences that you no longer want to have in the video, and then hit the backspace key on your keyboard or the little delete button that appears above the highlighted section. This will make a complete cut on the video so that nobody will know that you ever messed up. And if you ever want to put anything back, there's a little undo button there that you can click and it'll set everything back to how it was previously. Now, as a fun little aspect of Type Studio that I'm gonna throw in there is that if you ever need any high quality stock images, the integration with Pexels just got done. So just click the add image icon and then search through the thousands of free to use high quality stock images that can help make your presentation stand out a little bit. Just click on the one that you want after searching through it, and it will be added just like any other image. Another feature of Type that one could use for a presentation would be the use of the add text feature. Once again, highlight a section that you would like to add text, and then instead of clicking the add image icon, you're going to click the add text icon, or some like to call it the little T. This text box can be altered to say whatever you want. You can play around with the colors and the positioning and even the background transparency. So, you know, if you forget to add something in your original presentation and you already downloaded everything, you're like, wow, I should have talked about that. You just add it right here. The same addition can also be used with our pre-made shape elements to add a little funness to your presentations. Type has a few shapes to choose from that you can use to add a bit of humor or direction in your video presentation. As you can see, I added a nice little arrow pointing to Schopenhauer here, so people know that's who I'm talking about. And as well as a little badge that says number one influence, you know, to add a little bit of humor to an otherwise dull presentation. As I've said before, some other features of Type Studio also provide you the ability to add subtitles and then translate those subtitles by going to the top and clicking the subtitle button and choosing what style of subtitles you would like to add to your presentation. The subtitles will be added on the screen. These two can be customized as well. And if for some reason you need to translate those subtitles into another language, you can do that really easily by clicking the translate button at the top and selecting the language you'd like to translate into. So for this instance, this presentation is about Friedrich Nietzsche, so it only makes sense to translate subtitles into German. And then when your video is all finished and you think it'll get you a decent grade, you're gonna wanna go up to the top right and start the export process and click export and then export video. And then after it renders out, here on the sharing page, you can click the download button and your video, your beautiful video project, will start downloading onto your computer. And then there you go, you passed, you did it. And it didn't take that long. Plus, again, you didn't need to learn a traditional video editor. It makes it nice and easy. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully that helped out a little bit. If you have any questions, whether it be anything about Type itself or any other video editors, go ahead and ask them in the comments down below. I make videos for a living, so I've interacted with almost all video editors at this point anyways. So if you have any questions, just ask. But this is my professional opinion and professional input on helping those of whom are not trying to learn all of those big name video editors just to do a video project. Thanks again, hit the subscribe button if you'd like. It's like the equivalent of adding a couple cents into a tip jar. But in this instance, you don't lose any money and it just changes a red button to gray. Anyways, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.